A child is taking from a homeless man. Is that a news story that we really want to hear in our local broadcasts, on our local media, and across our social media? See, social media has become an instantaneous way for people to hear about life across America and around the world. Twitter is probably one of the better channels for news. We also have other channels like MSN, Yahoo, Google, and others that offer news. Some person in the force or some person in the government changed my homepage to MSN. Or did it happen when someone uploaded a new or downloaded a new system on my computer that I didn't want at the end? You see, I was ignoring the upload or the download for the longest time because I didn't want the changes on my computer. And what pisses me off is that someone else chose to do it in the middle of the night as if they were helping me or helping you, and they weren't. They were violating the law, taking away my rights to say no. We have this happening all across America on our technology, that companies are violating our rights to say no to video games, to software, to things that are not standard on a phone. But here's the deal. Most of us can't tell what is standard on a phone and what is ancillary. Unless it's really clear that it's some game, but the truth is some game could be taking our information. It could be sharing it across the sound waves or the audio files or the Bluetooth networks or the Wi-Fi whenever we turn on things on. The thing I miss about my late wife's Toshiba computer that I bought her before someone destroyed it in my home was that it had a switch to turn the Wi-Fi on and off. So you could be working and you could have the Wi-Fi off technically and mechanically, and know that your computer was safe from the net. But the problem that we've run into now is that companies are no longer doing that, and they're taking off those switches and allowing other people and other companies to play in through back doors and Wi-Fi networks and VPNs and destroying our rights to say no.